We're in conversation here at Gibbs with Professor Helmut Schwarz, who is president of the von Humboldt Foundation. Professor, welcome, and thank you very much for joining us. Your area of expertise is the role of science funding in sustainable research. How do you succeed these days when global money is so tight?
There are fortunately a few people around, all the politicians, who have realized that funding science is the most promising way to make sure that we will be able to face challenges, global challenges. You cannot do it without supporting scientists from all over the world. Most problems are international problems. Most problems need to be addressed by networking. And that is, for example, what the Humboldt Foundation is doing. We have a network of 25,000 scientists and scholars from all over the world. We encourage them to interact with each other, to spend some time abroad, to broaden their cultural background. That is a way, in our view, to make sure that we can help to solve global problems. And politicians are, at least in some countries, ready to recognize that. They regard investing in science not as a kind of a subsidy, but as a real investment.
How do you find the balance between what is good for the world and also what is good for a country and what is good for the private sector? Often in scientific research, there is commercial imperative, and that the research is proprietorial and that people want to hold on to it for themselves. You're also saying networking and sharing is important. That's a tough debate to have, isn't it?
It is a tough debate, and of course it depends a little bit on the field. There are some areas in which the topics you have mentioned do matter, but in many areas, when you think, for example, about how do we face problems with environmental aspects, I don't think that is a topic which can be dealt with when you do not operate in a global way. And that is also recognized by private company. Of course, when you develop a drug, for example, you need to get a return of your investment. So there is a conflict. But it seems to me that for the real global issues, people have realized it's not enough that you think in national terms. And as far as science is concerned, that is by definition international. We do ignore any kind of borders. They do not exist at all. They are really artificial.
Ahead of this Rio conference, what, in your opinion, are the big funding priorities?
Well, I think the major problem is the provision of enough energy for the next 50 years or so. If we have enough energy, we can solve most of the problems. For example, water supply depends crucially on it. That is the major issue, in my view.
Again, is that on the universal agenda, though, or are there still specific interests that are dictating other priorities, perhaps?
I think it is now on the universal agenda. It is, at least in the last 10 years or so, people have realized if we do not manage to solve this problem, we will not be in a position to address any other serious problem. Provision of enough food is another example. Provision of infrastructure. How do you cope with problems in mega cities? Everything is related to the provision of affordable energy. That is the major issue.
Is the debate and the funding issue a different one in a developing economy such as South Africa's?
It is perhaps a different one, because people in these countries, they are facing so many day-to-day problems, though. And that is perhaps also part of our responsibility, to remind them, to support them, that in addition to solve these day-to-day problems, you also have to have a perspective, that you look, how can you cope with the problems which are lying ahead in 10 or in 20 years' time?
But often governments who are confronted with those day-to-day priorities, supplying electricity, putting food on people's tables, don't have that long-term vision.
That is more a problem of the politician. Yeah. That is, of course, we as a scientist, we have to remind them it's not enough that you deal with the problem for the next 4 years or so. The time scale matters. And it doesn't pay off if you ignore this long-term effect, because sooner or later you will be in no position that you can also deal with the day-to-day affairs if you do not address properly the longer problem.
So how would governments in developing economies achieve that balance then?
Perhaps by being a little less selfish? A little bit. That certainly helps. That certainly helps. And again, that is also a question of a little bit of enlightenment. It is a problem also on thinking a bit more globally. Not only underdeveloped or developing countries, also countries in Europe, they often have this self-centered view. But fortunately, there are a few politicians around who realized it's not enough. They will not survive if they will continue that way.
And Professor, final question to you. I'm interviewing you today in a business academic institution. Yeah. What would you say to business leaders who are watching us about the role and the responsibility that they have in this debate?
Invest more in basic research. That is what I would also keep telling people from industry.
Professor Schwarz, thank you very much.
Thank you.